sometimes how much what traces I got. But I think I don't actually know. I think that because we have the improved stasis chamber or pet incubator, the recovery time from this stasis might be faster than normal. I'm not sure if it was half an hour by default or half an hour with the improved incubator. So it's either we can use it immediately or in half an hour. And it's safe. How do I see how much time there's left? I probably cannot see it right now. So I guess we'll equip the taxon and do stuff then. Seeing how you two have been leveled up, it's time to change. But I should probably make room for your replacements. How many weapon slots do I actually have? 3. None. Probably sell you and you. And you. I guess you 3 will be enough. Primary weapon and secondary weapon. And it's going to be easier. And as for the secondary weapon. Pandero is looking pretty convincing right now. Let's take Seer instead. And you have 6 points to spend. I could install the overextended now. Then change the constitution to magical. They actually upgraded Mitre from what it was. Since this is the first time we are actually using this, there's nothing to really compare it to. But yeah, it has a pretty decent status chance and deals massive slash proportions. So I could maybe get something bleeding related working for it. Because equipping this will increase the status. guess bleeding is as good as gas in some sense. Both are AoE type of deals. No, not AoE. DOT. But gas itself is also AoE. So that's going to be worth exploring, maybe. But I'm not sure if this one comes with innate punch through stat. Actually, did I have a lower level? Well, I have lower thermite rounds. And I'd rather have 100% status chance for now. We have 4 left. We could put in basic serration. Actually saying that there's no critical chance involved, but I think they added it. You're actually able to use the terminal velocity as well. You'll see. This weapon should be awesome in dealing damage over time effects. If it's fast in killing enemies, even with that, we'll have to explore and see how it behaves. And there is a almost hit scan pistol that does not crit, but has decent damage otherwise. So we probably want to poison deal going with it. Poison and Witcher shot maybe. Yeah, it does not say here how long the cat still has to recover for. I'm guessing it's the half an hour. It's mine. That's interesting. I'm not actually seeing any alert missions. Even though it displayed earlier that we could have a Ayatan hunt, I think. So let's do that Ayatan hunt right now. And I might be looking at calling it a day as well soon.
From Maru's Bazaar. You've come. Lucky for you, I'm gonna... That's the spirit! Let's go!
I'm not sure how long I've been recording for, because I had to take that time out. I got the Steam message. But I don't think I've recorded for 2 hours yet. But sometimes I feel like doing shorter recording sessions. While we wait for the cat to
okay, the Ayatan treasure is marked on your map.
Stasis.
Time to go to work.
Also a good excuse for me.
The hunt is on, Tenno. The day early. Scanner is detecting a potential target. Use it. Search for traces of the target.
We can kill a single enemy because of the ancients involved. Because the healing aura the ancients provide seems to provide status chance or status effect immunity in the form of actually transferring the effect to the ancients. Whereas the damage that the target is putting in will also be reduced, so because the status effects damage over time, the portion is related to the damage that is dealt. What happens in that situation is that while the ancient healer, or the ancient will take the status effect itself will deal only a fraction of its normal damage. At least this is actually a Void Tower mission, so we might be able to get some mods here.
My, oh my, I think you found it.
Darken Crystal. And I guess that's a Baya.
Your job's done.
But yeah, I have to test if this mitre actually has punched through innately. No, it just reflects from the surface. Wonder how that behaves if I bet installs and punch through into this one. Shoot a few containers inside that sphere. Because I'm using a sentinel, I might be able to get to the contents that they had. But I don't think they dropped any mods. So I'm not sure if there's anything in there to interact with the vacuum ability. Probably built with enemies when I probably be interested in trying to regen some energy back and then activate my main ability. How silent is this mitre actually? Thank you. think I like this weapon a bit. It's going to be a... It is changes in the Pantera. One second. Finished leveling it up. That just means that we get to remake it at some point in the future. So I don't think that we have a crafting recipe to come back to the factory. Miter. It's a shame in that sense that it's pretty painful to farm for the miter. The boss fight. They get parts from an old leg drill. It's a big pain in the ass. Run. Okay, I don't think the standout uncharged shots have 100% status chance. Number of status based on the weapon bar. So what that means that base chance is significantly lower than 50%. My hunch is spot on, I'm going to say that it's 20%. So that's all well to add additional status chance mods to that even unshot shots dealing 100%. Status effects, so that might be worth exploring at some point. And of course I also want to put the multi-shot mod on it. Because that will also help in dealing status chances. Status effects. Yeah, it was weird that our alert window had disappeared, even though it should have displayed that we had that sculpture hunt available. Let's visit our dojo to see if our Temple of Honor... Yeah, it has been completed, so... That might make us eligible for the next dojo rank, 8000 endo, but I think this is still having its cooldown. Rather, its ceremony is still ongoing, which in normal clans that have more than one member would mean that while the ceremony is going, the other clan members could come and collect their endo. Is probably very useful for them. And why would you place the statue so that when we come from the main entrance we'll be looking at its back? Makes no sense. But yeah, I need to place a few more rooms. I'm not sure that this can actually fit the big rooms such as the observatory or the whatchamacallit. Yeah, it doesn't actually even show up here because it cannot fit in this location. So I'm guessing that this will be the dueling room because it also gives first build affinity. Make additional I might as well place a reactor on this side, because I have a feeling that I need to make a use of the other dead end that we have in our dojo, because this one can still hold a large room, like the observatory, as you can see, taking that much space. But I might also want to put the obstacle course here, because it's even more pain in the ass to fit. But I need to do some energy calculations. If this one's going to cost us 10, this one's going to cost us 5, the dueling room is going to cost us another 10. So we need 25 energy. Maybe we have enough capacity. It's 10. 2. 10. So 22. So we should have enough capacity as well. And that should leave us enough capacity for another reactor, I guess. We might also if the dueling room is going to be here, this one's going to be the obstacle course, and I was planning on placing the observatory on the other end, then that leaves us with full dead ends on all sides. And that's probably something that I want to avoid. So that means that I need to make another cross connector somewhere. I think we have to start making it here. Running out. Because this one's going to cost 10. Yeah, we'll have to make that one, because I don't think we can craft that before we had the Great Hall. And these ones. Well, that one has 6 doors. As well as this one. So I'm guessing that our dojo project just got slightly termer than before. But luckily we got 2 formats just now, so we can afford to make these changes. But in preparation I'll probably have to make another reactor as well. Location for it, even though this one fucks up our dojo layout royally. So I had intended for all the unusable rooms to be on the other side, and the labs, and rooms with a function to be on this side, but now I need to put the reactors here because I'm a dumbass. And that's going to affect stuff. Start crafting a cross connector here because we don't have the energy for it. And we do. What do I actually want to have an extended hallway to make room for a observatory on one side? I think that has to be done. can't start crafting this one because the other one's still not ready. It's not eligible to count for the tech tree until it's been finished. So let's start crafting an extended corridor here. Research situation on the tenor rifle. So I don't think I contributed everything yet. I still don't have the resources required, so let's not do a thing yet. So yeah, I guess I'm going to call it a day now. Next time we play, I'll probably try to get enough resources for the another research to finish. Is not going to be finished in ages because the Tenora is going to cost us 600 oxen. Yet to come up with a good mission where to get shit loads of oxen from. Except some of the invasion defenses against the corpus units, because those seem to give 200 per completion. So if we have where to go and finish such a mission, let's say Necros, for example, we'd be looking at maybe 300 oxium, maybe. Yeah. Until next time. Bye.